What's up, guys? All right, so we normally look at charts here to start out the show. Today we'll do something a little different. I'm gonna take a look at a few things and clarify what happens at the beginning of a major moving market. We've been seeing a lot of low caps really take off. We're seeing cloud computing, Internet of Things. There's some talk about artificial intelligence, AR leading the way, GameFi, a lot of things we've been mentioning on this show. All right, so let's take an in-depth look at this and what's trending. Here we got right at the top, premier low cap, Shiba, but we still have some majors, right? Bitcoin to Ethereum. We all know what's going on with Ethereum, but it gets interesting as you go further down. So we have Ambrosis, which is a cloud computing service. They're really trying to do more of a connectivity type of IoT, Internet of Things. Fairly recent major pump on this one. Polymath, right down the line. Decentralized distribution of data processing power. Golem, similar to Polymath. So as we go further down, we start to see really similar things pumping here. Keep Network, Loop Ring. A lot of these are services that provide some kind of clouding service, some kind of data computing processing power, where developers will deploy a lot of systems on it. They'll use it as cloud service for storage, for dApps. What does that mean to us as investors? What's happening here is that the market's really heating up, getting ready for GameFi. So a lot of these developers, they're going to be using these services to back up their systems on games, networks, metaverses, AI, AR. They all need these processing power. They need cloud computing services. They need databases to be distributed at high speeds. Taking us to the top gainers, top losers, we're starting to see a lot of the lower caps really fluctuate here. When we talk about games, gaming, metaverse, it's going to start really putting eyes on the market. What's kind of happening here, you've got major investors putting money and funding into projects, and that's what's really spurring a lot of this growth, a lot of this pump. These new projects will be using these services, and they'll be using that funding money to go deploy or develop on these cloud platforms, initiating cloud services, databasing products, and we're seeing it here. So IoT starting to take off. Logistics, tourism, a lot of that's going to be using AI. But metaverse will start to heat up. Gaming, this is still early, right? You need to be looking at this already because other people are. They're going to be using that VC funding money. We're going to see gaming and metaverse rise up this list. And a lot of these ventures portfolios will continue to be really solid. So let's take a look at those. These are the top gaming coins. Multi-gaming platforms like Gala, Engine. These are ecosystems, metaverse plays. They're going to really start to put eyes back into crypto. And then you'll see the big boys. You start to see a shift where liquidity, and it'll start moving back into the mids and the high caps. But until then, we need to start a run. And you start it off almost every time with low caps, gaming. You know, we're looking at Galaxy Digital's portfolio, one of the major holders of Bitcoin and Ethereum. They're getting into a lot of other things, Solana being one of them. Kin, very interesting play on Solana. Gari Network had a massive run at the end of last year. Wax, just a massive, excellent GameFi ecosystem with NFTs involved. We saw a lot of talk, and we're seeing a lot of reaction for Flow and the Flowverse at the news of Meta. Alameda Research, one of the major investors in Solana, led by none other, Sam Bankman-Fried. These are good places to lay your hat and take a starting look at what you might be interested in. A lot of major talk around Render Token, very similar cloud computing services, distributed networks on computing power processing. One of those plays where they could lead that metaverse market, just like Golem and Polymath. A lot of these portfolios are really diversified too. So if, you know, DeFi will start to be at near the top. When you get sort of peak, you know, people are going to start looking for yield when they're taking out principal, looking for places to store their money. This cycle, it could be very different. The peak could look a lot different because the crypto floor, you know, the user base is getting deeper and deeper. A lot of people constantly been talking about audience, but we're still waiting for the music industry to really kick off. But what's going to be really important to know about music industry in crypto is that they're going to need a lot of distributing and computing power. They're going to need a lot of storage network. And so let's take a look at that, right? Distributed computing tokens, ICP, Filecoin. So these guys are going to be at the top of the list because they're known. What we want to try and do, right, is find those undervalued tokens that have massive potential. Siacoin, we talked about Siacoin several shows ago. Siacoin's really interesting. Their Skynet had been in development for quite some time. They've got a somewhat larger supply, right? 51 billion. But in contrast to other options, you know, Siacoin is an extremely intriguing investment there. Handshake, not very well known, something to look at. RevChain, been around for quite some time. If they're still building, it could be something, right? Golem, one of the major players in distributing computing power. And so, you know, we really like to talk about Solana here, and a few interesting things about Solana in this cycle. Solana's really building up a user base. We talked about Ethereum NFTs and where they are historically. It's very, very arguable that Solana NFTs are runner-up to Ethereum, and maybe, you know, we're looking at Crypto Slam lately, the transaction count. All it's going to take is for some more value to enter back into Sol coin itself. And revenue on things like Magic Eden and crypto transactions overall could really, really start to change the face of NFTs and for Solana NFT holders. If we're going to look at the Solana ecosystem, if gaming is going to make a massive run here, Solana is definitely worth taking a look at, especially if you're interested in gaming. Solana is very much primed for high volume, quick transaction rate on YouTube and things like that. You see fractal.is. The games and developers are getting better. Alameda Research is a very active investment group. A lot of funding, a lot of executives changing hands. So a lot of people are gonna be looking to make major plays, gonna be looking to make names for themselves, gonna be wanting to put their VC on the map. So this cycle could be really interesting, right? Especially when you have a lot more eyes on crypto. We see the moves that Star Atlas has been making. They've been putting a lot into this network. It's been taking some major fire, but you know, the quality of gameplay there is something to recognize. And although if you're familiar with the type of space type exploration, massive multiplayer type worlds that Star Atlas is trying to provide, we've seen those before on Eve, where it just looks like it would be so meaningful, but it has a really difficult time grabbing hold. However, when you add in the tokenomics and the possibility of earning, Star Atlas has a lot to work on with that, but it gives you a different perspective. It provides a different perspective for looking at gaming in crypto. So Akash, max supply, just 388 million versus the market cap right now and diluted just under a third of the total supply. Market cap under 40 million. Don't let the short term frame fool you. There's a lot to be gained here. It's right on the lines of what we want to lead into the market. It's got a lot of projects that are really good on it already, have been building for quite some time. So this is a P2P, peer-to-peer cloud computing system where, you know, you can deploy your dApps from. You can bid and manage your server from here on a cloud network. So a lot to be had for a developer and a lot to look at as an investor here. And now Solanium is a really cool launchpad. They are multi-chain. Most of what you want to do on Solanium, you'll be investing in projects with USDC. There hasn't been anything recently, but when crypto starts to really heat up, these are the sort of launchpads that you're going to want to look for. You're going to want to check out these opportunities and get in early. We saw how well DarlyGo did. Iceberg Chain on the Confluence side, if and when gaming really starts to take foot. You know, low caps, games, GameFi, metaverse is included in GameFi. A lot of these type of projects, they'll lead the way. They'll start to bring, people back into the market. It piques interest, and just about everybody in crypto had at one time believed that gaming is what's going to bring in the mass market. Gaming is what's going to really take crypto mainstream, and so you need to develop that ecosystem that's going to back that. You need to build that infrastructure, and so right now we're still fairly early in crypto. We're on the early side of the curve, and we're still looking at investing in infrastructure, right? Polymath, Ambrosis, Golem, Akash, you know, Loopring. These are all really excellent infrastructure investments. And arguably Helium, But Helium, you need to do something else to, you can't really, you got to mine the coin, but that's something worth taking a look if that's what you're interested in. And then you'll have low caps that'll bring in that interest, right? Possibly some new liquidity. So it's an easy entry. It's easy to dabble on low caps. We talked about Terra Classic and it being a low cap, but it's got something much different than a low cap, right? And on that note, we'll check charts really quickly, but kind of wanted to just point this out. So we mapped out on the log hash a really nice looking bottom triangle on the third here, and it's following perfectly right along. This was uncharted territory, so there was really not much to go off of, but Terra Classic following the third, massive moves up the speed. We mentioned that I would be looking to stay up on here, but a breakdown had been happening. So breakdowns happen, but it has never taken us into the lower third. If I'm wanting to draw some resistances here, or at least come up with a forecast, then I'm gonna project off of this. Rough estimate here, but looking for a rise. So on a quick third, if it breaks 6006, who knows? This rise up is extremely unique, super fun. All right, and we'll check Bitcoin. So same charts from about 3 weeks ago now, maybe even longer, late July. Or mid late July, we started here. We've been running channeling here, 32 degree angles on a 20 point time frame is what we mapped out on the speed resistance fan. All right, so we'll take a look at our long term behavior on the Elliott. One month candles taking us straight down this perforated trend line in the corrective market here. We've still been looking for five, if this is a five, to confirm. If it was C, if we're looking at the longer term three move on the corrective side, C had already concluded, taking us about just almost 10% into wave one, which is a requirement to satisfy C. So is it bottom? Have we bottomed? And now we're looking for the move up. Not necessarily, not super clear yet. We've been talking about channeling here, 21, 5, 17, 5-ish. So if we take a look at the 4 hour here, we're still trying to touch on this behavior at 17.5, which would be like more like completing wave five here on the longer term, which would stretch C down to wherever five completes. Let's look at the 1 day. So we use the 1 day to maybe come up with a forecast here. Yeah, so new trend here. Possibility of a new trend. See how likely it'll be for things to change here. So let's play a little conservative on a 46. So if we're gonna get a little bit more pressure here and continue to take us into actual trading flat here, I don't think there's enough pressure here. We'd be looking at possibly breaking down in a day or two and taking us along this, and where we break our longer term trend line here. And that would be really interesting news, because then we'd be at that point ready to confirm if we're 5, or confirming that we are concluding out C, we have concluded out C, and we're ready to move on. However, we did note that we had some overflap here that might need some doubling up on this side. We did see it here, although we're not getting a clear version of that. We have been talking about being on the lower side, the lower end, in these early weeks. So we're running about halfway. So I'm getting ready to admit that we need to take a different look. I'm getting ready for that, but I still think that we're on the same path. So we'll keep looking at it in the coming days. If you're really looking for confirmation, we should really start to get it at some point this week. Take a look at some Solana NFTs, which really staying strong lately. Really gave Ethereum a run for its money this past several days. Still at a close number 2, ETH starting to pull away again. Seeing a lot of liquidity leave Solana, possibly go back into ETH. Well, that's cool. You guys will be back, and we'll be glad to have you. But yep, so Solana NFTs chugging along. A lot of projects still moving up. We're seeing a nice retracement here on the overall market. Aliens, little over 2 SOL a day and a half ago. So Deads, little over 2. Love these two projects. Excellent community, excellent leaders. Just Worms, I'm not in yet, but I'm watching it tonight. Breeder Boys, somewhat of a DeFi play. A lot of options on this one. Bridge Split looks like it's going to be what they call deprecated. So I'm not sure if they're going to move to another platform, but this is where you can deposit some NFTs and get some the Bird coin and make some interesting plays. We talked about birdeye.so, you know, trading NFT coins. And if you're looking into those sort of things, there's a lot of really interesting options. ABC, Meta, still trending more or less, but kind of starting to really fade a little bit, maybe in the short term only. We'll see how it does. But I think we're starting to see some of those utility plays gain back some market share. Thug Monkey's making the chart, making the trend here. Mischievous Maxis. King Fud still working on that come up on his D-Rug. And so ABC's pulled back to 50, back to 65 here. I had forgotten to mention Goofy Gorillas. But another 0% royalty project here. Saw a lot of really nice trading action yesterday and the day before. Had a run up to nearly 1 SOL. So looking forward to Goofy Gorillas getting back up there. So here's Solstice still claiming he has nothing to do with, or has no intentions of pumping the floor. So it's up to us, Soul community. So I guess see you at zero. No, I'm playing. But all right, we'll leave it there. And Goofy Gorilla Gang, if it is up to us, Soul community, I'll see you at 10 Soul. All right, have fun, trade safe, see you on the next one.